Right, so we head into Parliament now, where the minority has criticised government for organising sword-cutting events for the construction of road projects which never gets done. Ranking member of the Roads and Transport Committee, Kwame Agbuja, cited the Tamale Interchange and other road projects. He wants government to immediately cease the ceremonial sword-cutting and fix the road infrastructure deficit.
As soon as we took power in 2017, a committee was formed, and the chairman of that committee was Honorable Edun. This is what we did. Projects who were to commence were put on hold because there was no way we could be able to pay 17.2 billion within 4 years. If it is a drain, that is going to cost us too much, but we can construct one side of the drain for the road to work technically. We do that. That is what is termed rescoping. Mr. Speaker, termination of non-performing contracts which the previous government has awarded were also terminated. Mr. Speaker, when all these things were done, we were able to reduce the 17.2 million commitment to 5.7 billion. Mr. Speaker, that is what is called prudent management of the road sector.
The minister says that the end of the interchange is a three-tier interchange. Mr. Speaker, the truth is that the phase that we are doing now is just two-tier. If we are going to have a third level, that will have to be another agreement or another negotiation taking place. So let's manage our expectation. By the time they finish this phase, you are not going to see a three-tier. You are going to see a two-tier. And we commend government as well for continuing with what the NDC have started. This budget doesn't show any sign that this is a year of growth for this government, because the monies allocated to the road ministry is paltry and cannot pay even the arrears, let alone building two additional 2,200 kilometers of new road at the cost of $2.4 billion, Mr. Speaker. I shudder to say, this is not a year of growth for Ghana. This is just a year of propaganda. And we tell the road minister, come back to the house or go to your office, negotiate with the finance minister, get the money to the contractors to do the road. Shortcutting doesn't build roads.